Welcome to the next topic in electrical machines. We were discussing the DC machines, and in this lecture we'll focus on losses and efficiency of a DC machine. So losses in a DC machine can be classified into the copper loss, iron loss, stray loss and mechanical losses. Whereas the copper loss and iron loss together can be classified into the the loss which is known as the eddy current loss and the hysteresis loss. So here you will have the eddy current, okay, and the mechanical losses can be classified into friction loss and the windage loss. So losses together in a DC machine can be of copper loss, iron loss, stray loss and mechanical loss. And the iron loss is also known as the core loss or the magnetic losses, which is a combination of the hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. Mechanical losses can be friction loss and windage loss. So first we will see the copper loss. Copper loss generally occur due to current in the various winding. So loss can be there in the armature copper, shunt field copper loss and series field copper loss. So armature copper loss, any copper loss can be given as I square R. So if the resistance is taken as the armature resistance with a current of armature current, then it is known as armature copper loss. This includes 3 to 6% of the total loss. Shunt field copper loss will be given by ISH square into RSH. RSH is the resistance of the shunt field winding, where ISH is the current in the shunt field winding. Series copper loss will be given as IS square RSE. And RSE is basically the resistance of the series field winding, and ISE is the current in the series field winding. So it constitutes around 1.5%. So in addition, the brush contact drop, whatever the loss associated with the brush contact drop, that is enclosed in the armature copper loss. Now, next loss is iron loss. So iron loss in the armature is due to the rotation of the core material in the magnetic field of the poles. So here you have the hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. So the analytical equation of the hysteresis loss and eddy current loss are given, whereas the hysteresis loss, you have the magnetic B max to the power 1.6 frequency into voltage, whereas the constant is there KH, known as hysteresis constant. Eddy current loss will have a constant KE multiplied with B max square, that is the flux density square, frequency square into voltage. So if the frequency increases or the magnetic flux density increase or the voltage increase, then the loss, that is the iron loss, will increase. This constitute a quite an amount, that is 20 to 30% of the full load losses. Next you have the mechanical loss. Mechanical losses are basically the rotational losses. It constitute around 3 to 5%. It can be due to friction in the bearing or the brushes during rotation, or windage, which is the air friction of the rotating coil. So these laws rely on the speed of the machine. So at which speed the machine is rotated, that depends, that govern the mechanical losses. Stray losses are around 1% of the full load output power. They are generally neglected, the stray losses, and they are the miscellaneous losses, which is very difficult to calculate to a reasonable value. So it can calculate up to a reasonable value, but it is not possible to get the accurate amount of the stray losses. So it is due to the distortion of the flux because of armature reaction and short circuit current in the coil undergoing commutation. So stray losses are because of flux distortion or short circuit current. They are the miscellaneous losses. Now if we classify the losses into two types, one is constant loss, another is the variable loss, then iron loss, mechanical loss and shunt field loss, these three losses will come under constant losses. We know that in the shunt field, it is a constant flux. So if the shunt field losses will come under the constant losses, because entire voltage is being applied here. Variable loss is due to copper loss in the armature and copper loss in the series field. So total loss can be written as the sum of the constant losses plus variable losses. Now let us see the power flow in the DC machine. So first we'll consider the DC generator and then we will focus on the DC motor. So in the DC generator, we know that the mechanical energy is converted to electrical energy output, electrical energy. Then the losses, we have the mechanical losses first, then core losses, then we have copper losses, and then we have stray losses to get the electrical power output. When on the other hand, when you have a motor, then you will be having electrical power input and you will be getting the mechanical power output. So first you will be having the copper loss, then you will have the core loss, then mechanical losses, and then stray losses. So having known this power flow diagram, it will be easy to calculate the efficiency of the machine. So power stages and efficiency. So let us consider three stages, A, B, and C. So here we have taken the mechanical power input of the machine, which is the output of the driving engine. So if you take the mechanical power input, so this is the motor to generator flow from this side, and from here to here you will be having this motor to generator will be this side, it will be going from mechanical power input to electrical power output. So it is basically you are getting electrical power output, so it is a generator. If you go from A to B to B to C, then this side you will get a generator action. Now from here if you go, then electrical power input you are taking and mechanical power output you are taking, so this is basically a motor principle. So here what are the losses you have? Iron and friction losses will be accounted first when it is in the generator action, and then you can substitute the copper loss. In between it, here you will be having the generated power, which is the generated EMF into the armature current, and at the output you will be having the load voltage into load current. On the other hand, if it is working as a motor, so this will be acting as the, you know, the input power, and here you will be getting the mechanical power developed. So three efficiency we can calculate. One is mechanical efficiency, second is electrical efficiency, and third one is overall commercial efficiency. So if you are going for mechanical efficiency, it is B by A. So here B is the power developed in the armature, that is EG into IA divided by A, that is the output of the driving machine or the mechanical power supplied. If you go for electrical efficiency, it is C by B. So divide the C with B, then you will be having the load voltage, that is V into I divided by the generated voltage EG into IA. Because this is basically taking place inside the generator, so it is giving you the electrical efficiency. This is taking place at the shaft too, so it is mechanical efficiency. Overall commercial efficiency is the net output power by net input power. So what is the watt available in the load circuit by what is the mechanical power supplied? That is the commercial or the overall efficiency. So then we have to note that unless specified otherwise, commercial efficiency is always understood. So we will be understanding the commercial efficiency, and if it is deliberately mentioned to calculate the electrical efficiency or mechanical efficiency, we have to take into account that. So what is the condition when we can get the efficiency to be maximum? So efficiency will be maximum under which condition? So that derivation we will do, considering it to be a generator. So generator output is V into I, that is the voltage multiplied with the current. So generator input is equal to output plus losses. So VI is the output, and you have some fixed losses or the constant losses plus the losses in the armature, that is IA square RA. Now, if we consider this to be a shunt machine, that is, if you have a machine where you have the field winding connected in parallel with the armature, then in that case, the armature current IA will be divided into your shunt current and the load current IL. So you can divide the armature current into sum of the shunt current, that is the field current, plus the current which is flowing in the load terminal. So your generator input you have got. We know that the shunt current is very negligible as compared to the load current, then you can neglect this amount of the current and entire armature current you can consider to be flowing in the load. Now efficiency is basically the power output by power input. So power output we have calculated as VI, whereas the power input we can take considering that the shunt current is zero. Now In this case, since the entire armature current is flowing in the load current, we can write this expression, and on dividing the numerator and denominator by voltage, we can get this expression. So we have divided the numerator and denominator with voltage. Now, since we have to determine what condition will get maximum efficiency, so this particular equation has to be take the derivative with respect to the current, then only we will be getting what conditions we get for maximum efficiency. So denominator has to be minimum for efficiency to be maximum. So divide, take the differentiation with respect to the current and equate with zero, you will get a condition I square Ra is equal to Wc, where Wc is the constant losses and I square Ra is basically the losses in the armature, which is the variable loss. So generator efficiency is maximum under the condition that the variable loss is equal to the constant loss. So these conditions we are getting for the generator efficiency to be maximum. And if we want to find at what load current you will get the maximum efficiency, then you will get the current I square Ra equal to Wc, you put it, and you'll find the current at the current I under root Wc by Ra, you will be getting the efficiency to be maximum. So the condition is variable loss is equal to constant loss, you get a maximum efficiency, and the current is equal to under root Wc by Ra. Now, if you draw the efficiency curve with respect to load current, so load current is on the x-axis, and on the y-axis, if you get an efficiency curve, then you will see that, and the losses, if you also account, then there are two types of losses. One is the fixed loss, which is parallel to the x-axis, that is the load current, and your variable loss will keep on increasing with the load current. So this is variable loss, and the point of intersection of the fixed loss and the variable loss, you will be getting the efficiency to be maximum. So at this point, your efficiency curve is like this. So you are getting a maximum efficiency at this point, and the corresponding current under which you are getting the maximum efficiency I is equal to under root of constant losses divided by Ra. So here you are getting the maximum efficiency. So we have seen the different losses in the DC machine, whether it is operating as a generator or a motor, and we have also calculated the condition for the maximum efficiency and at what current the maximum efficiency can be achieved. Okay, thank you for now.